How do you expect to be champ if you won't ring?
But, Daddy, I don't want to be champion. I want to be a great violinist.
Come on, come on. Up with the Dukes. Elmer, Elmer, where are you, Elmer? Say, son, how would you like to play at a concert?
A real concert?
Sure, a real concert. Just like Mr. Chrysler. He probably hit a bad note.
Bring him on.
Kangaroo killer leaps across the ring with the ferocity of a caged panther ready for the kill. He's winding up his famous tornado punch and lets it go, but the kangaroo kid ducks with the cadenza. The kid is a marvel of coolness. Now he's plucking the G-string, goes to a pizzicato. The killer aims and misses. He misses again, but the kid counters with a sonata. The killer is furious. Now he looks to his corner. He winds up that haymaker. He lets it go. Oh, boy, right on the whiskers. And there's the bell.
The round ended with the killer connecting with his famous tornado punch, which always spells disaster. But the kid fell into the ropes and was saved by the bell at the count of nine.
Poor Elmer. Associating with those ruffians.
Now the kid is coming out of it. He gets up on his feet, ready for round two. The killer appears worried. This is not what he expected.
Give us a load.
Uh-huh. There's dirty work afoot. And there's the bell for the beginning of round two. The killer cautiously works his way to the center of the ring, his gloves loaded with dynamite, looking for an early knockout. But the kid appears unconcerned. Such technique, such fingering, a true master of the Stradivarius. The killer raises his glove with great effort, but the kid ducks with ease. The killer loses his balance. He staggers across the ring. He falls over the ropes. And again, he looks to his corner for help. With a burst of speed, a shower of sparks, the killer sails through the air like the man from Mars. Whoa! What a blow!
What a fight! What punishment! Can the kid take it? Can he continue?
Oh, my poor Elmer.
The seconds are working frantically to bring the kid to. He's coming out of it. He's opening his eyes.
You broke my fiddle.
Now the kid is leading. He follows the killer around with lefts and rights, and the crowd is mad. He beats a steady tattoo on the killer's body. He sinks one into the killer's stomach and then to the jaw. Oh, boy, what an uppercut, another uppercut. And the killer's teeth are out. No, they're in. No, they're out.
Come on, Elmer, use the corkscrew punch. You know what I mean.
Atta boy, Elmer, atta boy. Don't you break the print basket, the big tramp.
The kid smacks the killer with his famous haymaker, and the killer sails through the air into the ropes. Now he's out again and retaliates with a terrific butt to the stomach. The kid falls out of the ring, and it looks like the fight is over. They're trying hard to bring the kid out of it. Can they do it? Can they patch him up for one more effort? Yes, sir, they've done it. Now the kid is going back into the ring. Listen to that crowd cheer. The kid is giving the killer a terrific going over. Now he's jabbing his head back with those lightning jabs. The killer never saw so many boxing gloves. Again he goes over the killer's stomach, and again those jabs are setting the killer back on his heels. The killer is in distress. The kid's bombarding the killer with lefts and rights. The killer is down. He's up again. He's down again.
Thank you. Thank you.
The kid is taking his time. He winds up his famous corkscrew punch and lets it go. Wow, what a punch. A real haymaker. And here comes the referee.
One. Two.
Son, I'm proud of you. The new champion.
Three.